Hello, in this video we are going to continue with the little building we built in the last video. Today we are going to look at layers and also bodies. So let's dig right in. Now let's say you're going to do some decoration and put some props into these floors. And it's really tricky to get into this floor and then down to this one and look around with the camera, and it's difficult. Then it might be a good choice to use layers. And layers works for groups. So for example, I select this group, floor 1. And here in the layer field, I type floor underscore 1. And you can't use spaces here because using spaces separates the layer names. So using a space here, you would assign 2 layer names to this group. So floor 1. And what happens now is that you can see that floor 1 turns up out here in the layers menu. I select floor 2. Floor 2. And floor 3. And I type floor 3 in the layer field. And our building is gone. But I can bring it back by clicking on these layer names out here to activate them. So let's activate all of them. And I'm going to show you the show hide command. So let's say I select this floor 2 group. I go up here in the view menu. And here we have the hide option with the shortcut H. And if I click that, you can see that floor 2 disappeared. But if I start the game, floor 2 is still here. But it's not in the editor. So what is hidden with the hide command in the editor does not affect what's hidden in the actual game when the map is run. So I press Ctrl A to show everything. But if I instead turn off this floor 2 layer and start the game, now floor 2 is gone. So this is important to keep in mind if you use layers in your levels. When you load a level through script, you can specify which layers in that level should be loaded. So the last thing I want to show you in this video is the body node. So let's go down here on ground level. And let's say that we want to make a crate. I click my main node, I right click, select new, and a group. And I use P to place that group right here in front of the building. I name the group crate. And in this crate group, I create a new voxbox, which is made of wood. Let's give it a woodish color. Something like that. And I create a simple crate. Duplicate. Rotate. Scale a little bit. Duplicate. And there we have our crate. I can't do anything with my crate. Yeah, I can break it, but nothing else. Aha, of course, I need to go in here and set all these to prop true. So they are dynamic. And now I can lift my crate. No, it wasn't really what I wanted. Let's undo that. Instead, I select my crate parts, right click, and I select put in body. Now all those parts constitute one body. And when you create a body, it is dynamic by default. And unless you have very, very good and specific reasons to make a static body, that is a body where the property dynamic is false, you should always leave the bodies as dynamic. So now if we go into the game again, we can see that the game handles those crate shapes as one single body. And I could even select these parts and make it into a compound. And in this situation, I think that would be a good move. Yes, there's a majority of air inside the crate, but the crate is still such a small object that the benefit of compounding these shapes into one outweighs the small air space we have here inside the crate. So, that's all for this video. See you next time.